guys. How are you doing? Today we're going to talk about guaranteed investment funds, otherwise known as segregated funds. We're going to talk about what they are, what that guarantee is, how they work. Do I think they're great? And I'm going to talk about a client experience that we just had with these, just to sort of give you an idea of what's happening out there in the industry. We've seen quite a bit of this recently, so I figured it was a good time to talk about segregated funds again. At the end of this video or in the comments, there's going to be a whole lot of salespeople that work for these big firms that sell this product that are going to absolutely hate this video. But we can argue with them, no problem. What are segregated funds? They're basically identical to mutual funds, except they're the insurance industry's, you know, product that is replacing mutual funds. So the investments inside them are pretty much identical to mutual funds, except because they're part of the insurance industry, they get to come with a couple other bells and whistles, which allows them to strap the word guarantee onto this product. And every single time I see this word guarantee on this product, I think of the glorious Tommy Boy quote, the great, late, great Chris Farley. He's talking to his customer and his customer says, "But why do they put a guarantee on the box?" And Farley says, "Because they know all they sold you was a box full of shit." Oh no, that's not what he said. No, that was not the direct quote. He says, "Because they know all they sold you was a guaranteed piece of shit." You can absolutely love it. I wish we could pull up Farley actually saying it. All right, so like, what is this guarantee and is it worth it? Well, that's what we're going to talk about. All right, so what is the guarantee? Does it cost anything and is it worth it? Well, you probably guessed from the quote that I just used that I don't think it's worth it, but let's actually get into it and talk about it. Now, there are some differences between mutual funds and segregated funds, so we're going to talk about those. And like you guys know, I don't love mutual funds in this country. They're sold by an army of salespeople, by the big financial institutions. Generally speaking, they're charging way too much for these products. You're losing a whole bunch of your potential returns to the high MERs on these things, and you're not getting appropriate advice in return. It is basically the reason why I started K4 8 years ago, is because I knew Canadians were being charged too much money. Mutual funds, if you think of them as like the guy that broke into my house last night trying to rob me, you know, generally speaking, that's fine. I got robbed. That was a really pleasant experience. Well, segregated funds are basically the equivalent of the guy coming to into my house, robbing me, and then lighting my house on fire. Basically, I feel like you're getting robbed by mutual funds in most cases, and in basically every case with segregated funds. And why do I say this? So mutual funds in this country generally cost somewhere between 1.8% to 2.5%. And segregated funds in this country generally cost about 0.5 higher than their mutual fund counterpart. So I've seen some well in excess of 3%, but a lot of them are about a 3% MER. So that means if you have $100,000 invested, you're going to be charged $3,000 per year for this segregated fund. Or in other terms, let's say that the market returns, you know, 3%. Well, you haven't even broken even yet because they're charging you 3%. So you're still looking at a 0% rate of return because 3% or $3,000 has gone to fees. Now, why are they charging this much? That's because you're paying for a guarantee. And there are two types of things going on here. So there's two guarantees that they're going to be suggesting that you have. And there are three types of product here. So we're going to talk about the guarantees and then the types of product. So the guarantees are the maturity guarantee. So that's saying, okay, you bought this investment and there's going to be a maturity guarantee, which now in today's world is usually 15 years away. So it says, if your investment is worth less than you bought it for in 15 years, we are going to top you up to the original balance of your investment. So the thing about this part of the guarantee that I always find humorous is that there's almost no circumstance where anybody has bought an investment and then 15 years down the road, it is worth less than they bought it for. This would have to be like the worst market imaginable and the worst investment imaginable, basically. So that guarantee almost never does anything for anyone. Now, the one that's a little bit better is the death benefit guarantee, where it says, okay, well, if you pass away and the number is below what you bought it for, then the beneficiaries on this are going to get topped up to what you bought it for. So, you know, generally speaking, this isn't going to work either, but in some cases it might actually work out to the benefit of people because they bought, there's a big market correction right after that, and then they get drilled by a bus and, you know, this pays out to their beneficiaries. They won. Yay, they paid 3% to this product for a reason. That's absolutely amazing. Now, is this guarantee 100%? Used to be, not anymore. Now there's three of these options. So this is one thing they're probably not explaining very well. But the inexpensive option of segregated funds is, which is comparable to the pricing of mutual funds. This is how they're marketing it these days, is we're going to pay 75% at maturity and 75% at death, no matter what. So you're paying only 2.5% to get a guarantee that 75% of your investment is left over if you die or pass away or you reach maturity. One of the other things that isn't really talked about is like, okay, maturity is 15 years away. So you bought this at 65, which happens all the time. You're going to need that money in most cases. So you're going to be taking money out anyways. It's going to lower that guarantee. It's not like, oh, I put 100 grand in, but I'm taking out 5 grand a year. It's not like they're going to bump you back up to 100,000 or something in 15 years. They're going to have their own calculation on this. So that 75-75 guarantee to me is basically useless. I can't even think of a scenario where this would benefit anybody, but it is really inexpensive, only about 2.5% to get this. Then there's a 75-100 guarantee. So that's 75% on maturity and 100% on death, a little bit better, but that's going to cost a little bit more. And then there's the 100-100. I think we can guess which one that is. 100% at maturity, 100% at death. Now, there is one other thing that happens with these. It says, okay, well, if the money goes up, so you bought it for 100,000, it goes up to 120, you can reset your, you know, limit or maturity or whatever your money that you're going to protect with the gift up to 120,000, but that's going to reset the maturity 15 years down the line. So now you've been holding this product for 18 years and being charged an absolute fortune. So now I want to look at a scenario where, you know, this guarantee pays out and how worth it was it for this client. So I've just used the most simple math. Obviously, this isn't going to happen, but I gave it the benefit of the doubt. I said, you bought this for $100,000. In year two, it drops down to $95,000, never moves again. And in year 15, you get your maturity back. So you get $5,000 paid back to you. But let's look at the fees you paid over those 15 years if you're paying 3%. In year one, you pay $3,000. And in year two to 15, you pay $2,850 per year to this financial institution and advisor, and you've paid in 15 years $42,900 in fees on a product that hasn't given you a rate of return of anything. They give you $5,000 back. Now they're only up $37,900 in fees. Wow, you won. What a win-win for the client. You see why I like these so much. All right, so what else is there with seg funds? Is there anything good about seg funds? Well, let's talk about the bells and whistles, which are just absolutely awesome. One of the things is that seg funds just stopped using DSC in June of 2022. So that means that, thank goodness, nobody will ever have to pay or be locked into DSC once again. But there's still going to be people until 2029 that are going to have to pay penalties to sell or transfer out their segregated funds to buy better, lower cost investments. One of the selling features of segregated funds is that because it's an insurance product, you get to name a direct beneficiary, which they'll say is fantastic because then you can avoid probate in provinces where there's high probate. You can avoid, you know, the government having to deal in your affairs and all of these things. And it can happen a whole lot quicker if you're trying to deal with your estate. However, the thing that they don't really mention to anybody about this is that most Canadians, and most average Canadians, are kind of being sold this product. I don't think there's a whole bunch of really wealthy Canadians buying segregated funds, because the people that work at the firms that sell segregated funds aren't exactly dealing with the super high net worth people. And if they are and they're selling them to them, which I see sometimes, it boggles my absolute mind. You know, you've got $3 million and you're paying 3% a year or 2.5% because they give you a discount. Boggles my mind how much they make. But RSPs, LIRAs, RIFs, TFSAs, all of those types of accounts that most Canadians have all their money in, you can name direct beneficiaries on those accounts anyway. So you can avoid all those things that it's pretending to do. The only time that that would actually make any sense is if you have a non-registered account that's a segregated fund, that then you can make that avoid probate. But is that worth the cost? Generally speaking, probably not, unless you want some money to say, okay, I want this directly to go to pay final bills, final expenses. You know, there's a guarantee there. Maybe you want a small one. Because it's an insurance product, there is some potential creditor protection on this. So one of the reasons that I might talk about this to somebody is if they're a small business owner, they're in, you know, a volatile industry, something like that, they've got some money, they want to protect it from potential creditors down the line. So needless to say, I don't like these. I think they're a predatory product that are being sold by predatory salespeople that are only chasing commissions and not looking out for your best interest. You know, I'm probably going to get a lot of people that drink a lot of Kool-Aid coming into my comment section telling me I don't know absolutely anything and segregated funds are the best and they're really helping all their clients or whatever. Guess what? No, you're not. I know you're not, and I'm going to talk about this in just a second. This is the only product you're allowed to be able to sell, and you're doing it, and you're making an absolute fortune. And how do I know this? It's because I could sell these to everybody. I've never done it once. And if I did, I would make way more money than I make now. If I got all the people that work here to be like, you know what, go and sell some segregated funds. Let's make some cash. Let's do the right thing, because making cash is the right thing. Then we'd all be loaded. But we're not, because we're trying to do the right thing and give people better deals and not sell them crap that's got the word guaranteed stamped on the box. So let's talk about this client that just came across their desk. In good shape. She had three registered accounts. Her RSP was worth about $500,000. She had two other registered accounts, her TFSA and a LIRA, that totaled about $100,000. So $600,000 in total. We're looking at these statements and we're trying to figure out the fees. And the advisor was nice enough on the $500,000 account to give her the discounted rate. So she was only paying 2.29% on that $500,000 account. However, she was not given the same discounted rate on the other 100,000. So she's paying about 2.6% on the other 100. Obviously, you don't want to give her a discount on that. So in total, she's paying $13,800 in fees, has never received a retirement plan, doesn't know what her strategy should be, her meltdown strategy, RSP, you know, CPP, OAS timing. Is she going to be able to retire? How much is she going to be able to spend? All of these other things. But she does have $600,000 in these gifts that have direct beneficiaries named on them, which is absolutely fantastic. So we took a look, said, all right, well, we're going to give you a retirement plan. We're going to do all this stuff. If we move this money, we can drop your fees to 0.95% a year. This is going to be about $8,000 per year in savings in the first year. Plus, she's going to get advice. Plus, she's going to have ongoing service. Plus, she's going to be comfortable knowing that she can actually retire. And we're going to save her about $8,000 a year in fees, which calculated out over her lifetime, come in somewhere between $160,000 and $200,000 per year in just fee savings throughout her retirement, based on her assets depleting over time. It still adds up to that much. You think we're saving her $8,000 a year? That's more than an extra month per year in actual spending money that she can have, because it's not going to a giant financial corporation. It's as simple as that. So, pretty easy conversation for me to have whenever I see seg funds and clients in them, and then I tell them how much they cost and how much we can save them, and that we've had some really good meetings and they like us and our advice. It's quite easy for me to be like, let's save this money and transfer this money out. So we do that, and the next day she gets a text from the advisor that says, and this is what I want every single one of you to do if you look at your fees anywhere and you don't want to go to anybody else, you like where they're at, but you look at your fees and you're like, those are kind of high. Ask them if there's any way if they can reduce them. Because her first thing was like, can we talk about this? There's probably a way that we can reduce your fees. Well, how come you didn't do that in the first place? And then she says, okay, well, maybe you can still work with this person, but keep your investments here with us, which, no, because like the first thing is let's save you money and get you away from here. And then she was like, can you just please stay here? Because we had talked and you said that you were going to stay with us for a while. So if you do this, I'm going to have to pay back $8,000 in commissions to my company, because I sold you these things and I thought you were in it for the long term until you learned a little bit too much, because people like me and others online are actually calling out this BS in the industry. Yay for the little guy for once, which I think is amazing. So it would take K4 more than 3 years to make even 8,000 once. And that's K4. That's not me. That's not the advisor. That's just K4 that is going to take more than 3 years to make $8,000. Sorry, lady, but I'm more interested in the client saving you money than you having a commission so that she can stay with you long term and you can keep your commission. I hope you go out of business. I hate these things. That's the bottom line. So anyway, I just kind of wanted to talk about it. If you own seg funds, please take a closer look. Look at some other options. They're so expensive. They generally don't help. In some very small percentage cases, they might. But that's like betting on, you know, Donald Trump to win the election. You just never gonna happen. Thanks.